right, so here is the part two, the actual story to how Ryan saved my life without knowing who I am or knowing what he was doing. I was going through a really, really, we'll just say shit time, and I wasn't really happy with anything going on, you know. Music is usually my go-to, because that's what I've done my whole life. It's what I know, and it just keeps bringing drama and just misery. So basically, I couldn't go there, and bought a bike, the intention of just getting out. Bought the bike, but I didn't really use it. I was excited about it, but didn't have the motivation, I guess is what I'm looking for. I didn't have the motivation. But I've been watching YouTube videos of like Sam Pilgrim and Berm Park and, you know, videos like that. And I was just like, well, that shit's just like way over my pay grade, the stuff that these guys are doing. I would literally just probably hurt myself really bad if I tried to do this stuff. And one day, Ryan Van Duzer's videos popped up, and it was like almost a 2-hour video, and I was like, well, I got nothing to do. Let's see what this Great Divide thing is all about. And watching, you know, his videos, and I just went on a binge of just watching his videos after watching that one. The dude is so cheerful and just full of life. And I was like, shit, I wish I could be that way. And that's really where it started, was, man, I wish I could be like that. I wish I could just be that carefree and just open and free and just being a free spirit and just so friendly and so much love. And I just kept watching his videos, and I just started feeling better watching his videos. And then I find myself just starting to add things to my bike, you know, like a rear rack, you know, bags to be able to carry stuff in, because I was just going to use a book bag, and I saw so many videos about, you know, it works, it'll get the job done, but it's not as enjoyable to ride, you know. So I mean, I just went the route that Ryan went and walked into a pawn shop and found a couple GoPros there, and I was like, well, I've never done biking videos before, so let's try this, because I still love video editing. I still love doing videos. I mean, I'm really bad at it. First, you know, when the camera's on, I get words don't make sense kind of things. Like when I try to say like things of that sort, it comes out things of that such, and it's awful. And I said in the part one to this, that this is the first video on the channel. Well, it's not the first video on the channel. It's like the 80th or something like that. What I meant to say was it's the first video in the new way we're doing things or whatever. Like, I can't even talk right now. Back to how he saved me, just watching his videos and the way he is, you know, full of love, inspiration, and just, it gave me the motivation to get out and try to be like that. And just after, you know, one ride with, you know, no footage, just really going, I think I did 15 miles that day. I felt good for a couple days with even no riding, you know, no negative thoughts, no depression. I was just chill, I was relaxed, I was happy. So, I mean, it was Ryan Van Duzer that brought me through it. If anyone else is feeling this way, just know, like, dig through YouTube. Do what I do, the YouTube roulette, which is you just find something you like and just let it keep going to the next video and see where you are in 2 hours. It might be the weirdest transition to something else, or you might find, you know, someone that inspires you and you didn't even know you needed it kind of thing. So that's the story. I don't know why I didn't talk about it in the video part one, but that's the story. So if you haven't, I'd really appreciate if you guys would like my videos and subscribe to the channel. And if you want, turn on the bell so you can get notified. I plan on doing another ride this Sunday, which I believe would be the 13th. So I'll have another video up by Monday. I plan on filming everyone and uploading the videos the day of or the day after. So we'll see you on the next one.